Welcome to Microsoft Project 2016 tutorials. In this video, I will show you how to evaluate project progress using schedule variance and the tracking Gantt chart. If we look at the earned value table, the schedule variance indicates that we are ahead of schedule. There has been almost 900 worth of work completed that wasn't planned to be completed as of the status date. However, the schedule variance and the SPI are not directly related to time. Instead, these indicators attempt to measure time in dollars. More work has been done than what we planned in terms of cost. But by looking at the schedule variance, we don't know how the project is doing in terms of time, because we don't know if the work that has been completed ahead of schedule is critical or not. In order to find this out, we need to look at the variance table. Click on the View tab and then the drop-down table. Click on Variance here. We can see the actual or predicted start and finish dates for each activity and for the entire project, along with the planned or baseline start and finish dates. We will also see the start variance and the finish variance. For the activities that have been completed, the variance is based on the difference between the planned and the actual information. For the activities that have not been completed, the variance is based on what is predicted considering the current project progress so far. For this project, as of January 17, 2018, we started 4 days ahead of schedule, which is indicated by a negative number here. But we are actually 2 days behind schedule. Remember that the schedule variance told us that we had completed $900 worth of work that was not scheduled to be completed at this time. How can it be that we had a positive schedule variance and we're actually 2 days behind schedule? The reason is that the work that has been completed ahead of schedule is not critical. How well the project is doing in terms of time depends on how well we are doing on the critical path. It's possible to have a negative schedule variance and actually be ahead of schedule if we are completing critical activities ahead of schedule, even though some non-critical activities are behind schedule. In addition, it is possible to have a positive schedule variance yet be behind schedule if the critical activities are the activities behind schedule. The schedule variance is useful in telling us how the schedule is doing in terms of cost. But when reporting on how well the project is doing in terms of time, we must view the variance table or the tracking Gantt chart. The tracking Gantt chart is used for planning and will only start to develop once the baseline has been set and tracking information has been entered into the software. Click on the Gantt chart drop-down menu. Click on Tracking Gantt. Now you can see the actual information as compared to the planned information in the tracking Gantt chart. Okay, that is how to evaluate project progress using schedule variance and the tracking Gantt chart in Microsoft Project 2016. If you like this video, please subscribe and share. This is Yong Wang.